Hello there, friend. Today I want to talk a little bit about this animation style I like so much and that I use with all my characters. And if you wanted to give it a name, I guess you could call it, like, I don't know, traditional TV cartoon animation style. Really short and snappy name, I know. So how do you do this and what is necessary for that? I mean, the people who follow my YouTube channel for a while know that I've been talking a lot about this program I use a lot and that you see me using here right now is Adobe Character Animator, but this only does part of the job. You really have to kind of get into your performance and look into what is unique about this style I wanted to achieve and how can you incorporate this into your performance. By the way, this horse you're seeing here right now, it even has a name. It's called the Gift Horse. For no particular reason, by the way. But also, you can find a link down in the description to download this horse for free. Maybe you even want to work along in this video. Okay, how do they say on YouTube all the time? Let's dive right in. So why do I even want this kind of animation? Why can't I just go with what a character animator gives me out of the box? History has proven that this kind of animation is very popular and pretty engaging. And what I like most about it, it's not generic. I really see myself in it. Like the style, I feel like that's really me. One of the bigger reasons why I think it's good and why I like it is kind of an imperfection that these hand-drawn characters have. An audience can really relate with a specific degree of imperfection. Because it's human. But yeah, but I wanted to look into why can't we just take human motion? The main thing is that this kind of animation is kind of simplified and exaggerated at the same time. Everything is kind of isolated. It's a very clear language. So, but let's just look at some examples. First of all, I pulled up, it's The Simpsons. You can see, like, this guy here, it's just moving in like this, what we call pose to pose. Let's look at another example. It's always poses. Pose to pose. Pose to pose. That's basically what I'm trying to do. Take this amazing software, Adobe Character Animator, and add this kind of idea to it. There wouldn't be a good animation without any character. So let's pull up a character here. And I happen to have, as many of you know, made a couple of them. One of those is this gift horse I have here. I will show it to you. This is how it looks like. Your chance to actually own a horse today. But let's get back to animating. So I have pulled up this horse here. The next thing you would have to do is click this once. So it's selected. And then you click this little clapperboard down here, which will then create a scene for you. And this is its normal pose. It looks kind of natural. I would say we have to make some adjustments. I mean, I don't have to make many adjustments. The first thing I always do, it's already at 12 frames. We'll leave this length or the duration alone. What I want to do is make this 4K. Because then I can scale it up now. I can now go into my scene, which I already have opened. I click the horse and I find transform here. And now I can transform it. See, it's on a 50%, so it can go another 50%. We can make it double the size. And it's actually 4K. So I can later in editing, you can punch in on his face. So you can show him a wide shot of him, and then you can show like a medium shot of his upper body and his face. Let's go into our timeline now. And the first thing we want to do, either you record a performance or you use pre-recorded audio, which I actually almost always do. But for the sake of this tutorial, I will show you how you can actually do this. For example, if you want to do a live stream with this character, you will not be able to use pre-recorded audio because it's going to be live, and that's kind of the idea of it, right? So then you will have to use live performance. So what I always do, I would take off my glasses because my eyebrows are hard to see with these huge glasses on my face. So I'll take those off. Still, it looks kind of funky over here. So what you should do first, you should have your face in this circle over here. You should click on calibrate while you look at the character's face. and then it will reset to its neutral pose, and it will, you see now here, it started tracking my face. I mean, I did that before, but now it's calibrated. This, if you don't see the circle anymore and you see this face tracking marks, and you see these face tracking markers here, you know that it's calibrated. So now your neutral pose equals the horse's neutral pose. But for example, now I'm seeing, okay, it's kind of looking kind of angry. So I think it captured my neutral pose wrong, because whatever my eyebrows are at once I press this button, it will link that to the face. So my eyebrows must have been like this when I clicked the button, and then I went back to normal like this. And if you ever see that, you just try to look as neutral, make your face as neutral as you can, and do the whole thing again. And now if I relax my face, it doesn't look angry anymore. I can now look angry, surprised. Now it works. I can actually scooch over, and it will like really, you can really make nice movements with it. But what you can also do is just pivot your head around like this, and it will just move the head. And that might be something that is really funny, but you also have to kind of get used to it. Maybe it needs a little bit of practice. But the upside of that will be you will have like a more unique performance and your more unique animation later. So if you wanted to record specific things in separate takes, there's good reason for it, because you don't have to multitask. It could be very difficult and challenging to read off a script and at the same time focus on kind of the timing of your expressions or hitting the right keystrokes for specific gestures. So you actually have the option to isolate specific behaviors here on the right. And you only have to, for arming those, you only have to focus on those that have a bright red circle. The other ones are, you can just leave them. And once you hit the record button here, these will be recorded. The performance on those will be recorded. So let me go through those really quick. You have the dragger. The dragger means I can grab the arms, move them around. They get messed up sometimes a little bit. Looks also kind of funny. If you want to reset your puppet in general and also these arm positions, you can just click the refresh button down here. Next thing is lip sync. Lip sync you activate to, for that you have to activate your microphone, which is here. If I turn it off, you see, it doesn't work. If I turn it on, it works. But also if I turn this off, it will also not do anything. So you have to turn on those two. And once you're done with your lip syncing, you should turn off the microphone again, because whenever you record anything else in here, it will, if the microphone is on, it will record your audio again, and you will have a lot of audio tracks in here that you don't need. The triggers are the keyboard triggers. You have several ones here. You can change the hand with X and Y. I have some pre-recorded, you can press X or Y and you will have a pre-recorded hand gesture. I guess works like now it works with the camera, but you can also turn that off, turn on keyboard input, and then you can use the arrow keys to do it. And then you have face behaviors. You have several of those, same as with the triggers, which is basically the face tracking, the eyebrows and the head movement. And then you have this stuff that has like a dim red circle. You shouldn't mess with those. Just leave them on. For the sake of this tutorial, I will record the intro for this video, because I need it anyway. I'm kind of lazy. Hello there, friend. Today I want to talk a little bit about this animation style I like so much and that I use with all my characters. And if you wanted to give it a name, I guess you could call it like, I don't know, traditional TV cartoon animation style. Really short and snappy name, I know. So how do you think the people follow my YouTube channel for a while, know that I'm freaking about know that I'm freaking about the storm, I use a lot, I see you here now, I'm going to turn on here. And now if you play it back, you can see
what is unique about this my style I wanted to achieve, and how do you get this, how can you get,
I mean, it looks kind of nice, but what I couldn't do with all of this stuff going on, with the multitasking, with the key pressing, it's not really, really spot on. This could be better. I could actually just record my voice, bring it in, do all the lip syncing, and then do the whole posture thing and the movement of the head. And then in the third take, I could just focus on the hands moving and at the right time. And that's actually what I always do. I mean, you can go with this one. It's already it looks pretty good. But let's go through this workflow I use. So I have everything set up here now, as I had it earlier. I have the audio here that I want to use. So you can just drag and drop it like a WAV file into here. I will just drag this over here into my timelines. And let's see. Well, let's just pick like a small part so it's easier to... It's quicker to do. Let's see.
Today I want to talk a little bit. Hello there, friend.
So I will just take this little intro part. I will try to trim it.
Hello friend. Today I want to talk a little bit about this animation style I like so much and that I use with all my characters.
Just this little part. So now by pressing the Alt key and scrolling, you can zoom in and out, and I will play the first part.
Hello there, friend. Today I want to talk
everything I can remember, then reveal it in project panel, and it will give me the properties of this audio file. And it says, hello there, friend. And then it's important that you write it exactly like you'd said it.
Today I want to talk.
Want to talk. Like not want to, but want to. That's a good example. Today I want to talk. I talked about this in an older video and always used like an auto-translate tool. Like in Premiere you have a really good one. You can also upload it to YouTube and have it auto-translated there. But I don't really actually have too many shots of myself talking, so the fastest way is just to do it myself. And now you should click your horse in this case. And if you click on timeline, you go down to compute lip sync take from audio and transcript. And now it should be, I mean, you can still go in here and fine tune the pieces that are triggered, but most of the time it does a good job. So I have the lip sync now. I will click on my horse. What the next thing I will do is record my head movement. So now I'm going to activate my face back again. I deactivated it earlier. I will deactivate the lip sync, deactivate the dragger, because these things I don't want to record right now. The triggers, all of them, there are three of those. And I will leave on the eye gaze. Okay, so I will look at my character again, press the calibrate button, and now I can record it. And I will now have to focus on this one and this one, and you can also focus on just like this movement, and also it will record the eyebrows.
Hello there, friend. Today I want to talk a little bit about this animation style I like so much and that I use with all my characters.
So now I have the face movement and I have the voice generated. I can turn off all the face behaviors here on the right. Next thing I would do, you can activate all of the triggers. And now with Y and X, I can actually just use those while he's talking. Let's try that.
Hello there, friend. Today I want to talk a little bit about this animation style I like so much and that I use with all my characters.
So the only thing I want to change here right now is this bottle. I don't want to have him to have this bottle. So I will press D. And you can go in here and record a one frame take. But now I'm going to drag this out. And now if you play it, it will not be there anymore. This looks kind of weird, like this. It's just doing this gesture too late. So I will just do this.
I use with all my characters.
Yes, that's better.
Hello there, friend. Today I want to talk a little bit about this animation style I like so much and that I use with all my characters.
Nice. I like it. And you can just go out. And the easiest way is actually create a PNG sequence and then you can import it into your editing software. Okay, that's it. That's how I animate my characters. For me, it's not enough to just go into Character Animator and do some funky stuff in front of the camera and then use whatever comes out of it. I really deliberately go in and see how can I make this look like this kind of animation I love so much. As I said in the beginning, I have this gift horse here that is completely for free. You can find a link in the description. This is a great horse. It's the best horse. Awesome horse. I can't think of a reason why you wouldn't download it. I mean, who doesn't want to have a horse? I have one major question before I wrap this video up. And that is, what character should I do next? What do you guys want me to draw and animate next? Please tell me that in the comments. I would be very curious to know. All right, until then, take care. See you next time.